Academy, the Bluegrass Challenge Academy, it's called, at Fort Knox. It's one step beyond an alternative school, because these kids, their next step is probably prison, okay? But it's a military type school, and I visited there and spoke with every single student in the school over their lunch break. And one of the problems the school had was accreditation is not the right word. They tell me that's not it, but I'll just use, let's just use that word. They weren't accredited, and the general had been fighting this for 2 years, trying to get them accredited, because what it meant was, even though these students were studying the exact same materials in the other high schools, their credits didn't count when they were done. And so, you know what, my team and I took that on. We said, there's gotta be a way to get this done. You know what, we got it done. Yeah. We ended up pairing them with the Eminence Independent School District. I had toured that district and was really impressed with what the superintendent was doing there. And I knew he'd be open, and so they paired up. And you know what? The first class is graduating, I think, in a couple of weeks, and they invited me. And they said, he said, you know, this is incredible that these kids are, they're going to graduate from this. They will have their diplomas. And so it's amazing. It's just amazing what you can get done when you decide that government is supposed to be responsive to the people. It's just, it's really incredible. And to be in a position where I get to do that is even doubly incredible. So these are just some of the things that I've been working on, just voluntarily. Oh, I got to tell you this last one, military and veterans, because I am an Air Force vet. The military, and this is not my job description either. Actually, I don't have a job description, except what's in the Constitution, and it's really short. But military and veterans issues, I just take on because I know what it means to sacrifice your time when you serve in the military. Any veterans here today? Thank you for your service, and thank your family. In your careers have spent time away from your families, and maybe you miss holidays, maybe you miss your kids, you know, the first time they walked or talked, and you miss birthdays, and it's a sacrifice, and I don't think people fully understand that if they did not come from a military family. So I really mean it when I say thank you for your service. So if there's anything related to the military or veterans, I'll try to work that into my schedule. So that includes unveiling the Gold Star Monument in E-Town. I was actually there when the day they broke ground, and then the day they unveiled the monument itself, and it was just an amazing ceremony. They had a pretty large group of Gold Star family members there, and you know, you all know what a Gold Star family is. They've lost someone in the military service. And before they raised the Gold Star flag, they passed the flag around and let every family member touch it. And it was so moving, and then they raised the flag. So I attended that. Dedication, the Veterans Nursing Home in Radcliffe, when that one opened, I was there. And actually, I've been helping, trying to get the one in Bowling Green. I've been actually, I know the two gentlemen who did the footwork on that from scratch, trying to figure it out. I mean, they actually started from scratch. What do we do to get one here? And it looks like that's going to be moving ahead. They actually are moving to the next step. And I think it's going to be on the list for funding from the federal government. That was the next step. Honor flights. If you have not been on an honor flight, please try to do that, or if you don't do that, please be at the airport when these guys return. It is so moving. There's two different groups in Kentucky.